I think I was born and I was singing. Really, I was 3 years or 4 years old when I was singing with the radio. You know, I just heard songs in the radio and I was singing with. And then I performed in the garden for the other children. I just organized them. And yeah, I was always singing, always. This is my passion. I was 19. Then I decided, okay, no operetta, no musical opera. I had a very good singing teacher also at this time. Practicing, and I was also sometimes performing, but you know, in a very simple way, not in the big theater. But for me, stage is also a piece of paper. When I put a paper on the floor, and I say, okay, this is the stage, then I can feel, okay, this is something different. This is a different shape of the world, of the universe. This is just a very interesting feeling. It's changed everything when you are thinking, okay, I am on the stage. I am performing, I am singing in another character, in another life. I am not me anymore. I have so many. Kalas is the first one. But I love Renée Fleming. She is a great, great singer. I love her. But Birgit Nilsson was also my singing idol. She was a great, great Wagner and Strauss singer. And I heard a very interesting interview with her in the radio. She was asked about Isolde. That was her big, big role in Wagner, Tristan and Isolde. And they asked her, what is the most important thing for you to give a beautiful interpretation of Isolde? And she was so funny. She was a very funny person. She had a very nice sense of humor. And she said, you know what? I think I need good shoes. That's so funny. It was just, I remember always, good shoes. It's very important. I hope that they have this list and I will be on the top of this list. I don't know. If I understand your question good, I really don't know. I would love to be on the top. I would love to be, because singing and acting, not only singing, this gave me so much, and I can't live without music. I can't live without giving. You know, you understand what I mean? I love it. I was at home. I was practicing. I learned the role, and now I give it for you. And this is my life. And this. If this is enough to take me to the top, okay. If not enough, then I stay on the stage and I'm very happy because I love it and I do what I love. It's so interesting, you know, because the important stages of the world are the same. And also for me, it's just, you know, you can't see the audience. taxi. You see, maybe the conductor, maybe. I have to see. But I can see the conductor. And the first row from the audience is behind the conductor. And there is the end of my work. I'm here, I'm performing on the stage, and it could be metropolitan, it could be in Hungary, in Budapest, or here in Washington, here in Warner Theater. This is my place.